software is built in modules or layers. Different types of modules or layers of software, and these layers can interact or communicate with each other using a number of protocols or interfaces. Together, all these layers comprise the application. And layers could be static, meaning that they sit in the program and they will execute on invocation. Whenever another piece of software wants to run these modules, they will call them or invoke them. Or these modules can be dynamic, meaning that normally they're not in the software, but they will dynamically, when they're needed, come in, and somehow they would get linked in or dynamically join the main application, and then will be invoked at that time. What we do is we design the software, we design the different modules. So we start at the system level, for example, and then we focus down into the lower and lower and lower level of application. Or there's also that's a top-down approach, and then we have the bottom-up approach where we start with the smaller, lower level modules, and then we combine them together and build a larger application from that. And then we design interfaces between the various layers and protocols. We use well-known guidelines. A good software developer will know majority of these rules or guidelines. And also we have a lot of pitfalls that we try to avoid. These are also well-known issues. If a software developer does not avoid these pitfalls, what happens often is his software becomes like spaghetti, basically. It's all intertwined and hard to maintain. So it may work at first, but then somebody else comes in and tries to maintain it or tries to change it, and he will get lost because he will not understand the code, or he will understand it, but he may not understand it completely. He may miss out certain idiosyncrasies about the code, and when the code becomes big and bulky, you basically have to throw it away and start all over, because it will become impossible to maintain.